In this video, we will be going over how to maintain your status while on Stand OPT employment update. Upon receiving Stand OPT EAD card, you will need to upload a copy via the Stand OPT EAD upload eForm on the My ISSC eForm portal. If we notice any discrepancies with your EAD card, we will reach out to you regarding the next steps. Remember to report any demographic or address changes through the optional practical training links in your MyASU account. Unlike for post-OPT, you can only update your phone number and local address changes using the SEVP portal. All employment changes must be updated via eForm on the MyISSC eForm portal within 10 days of the change. To access the Stand Reporting eForm, please do the following. Go to myissc.asu.edu. Click on eForm Practical Training on the left side. Click on Stand OPT Extension Reporting. Here you will find all the reporting eForms needed during your Stand OPT period. Let's go over the type of updates you can make and what documents are needed for each update. Changes to current employer. If there are any changes to your current employer, you will need to submit an updated Form I-983 to the Stand OPT Employment Update eForm. Please be sure to submit pages 1 to 4 only. Change to a new employer. If you change to a new employer while on Stand OPT, you will need to submit the following documents to the Stand OPT Employment Update eForm. Final evaluation for your previous employer. The self-evaluations are on page 5 of Form I-983. For the final evaluation, you must fill out the bottom section of page 5. Evaluations must be signed by the student and their immediate supervisor. Secondly, you will need to submit a new Form I-983. Only pages 1 to 4 need to be filled out from your new employer. And employer. If you no longer work for an employer and are unemployed, you will need to submit a final evaluation to the Stand OPT Employment Update eForm. The self-evaluations are on page 5 of Form I-983. For the final evaluation, you must fill out the bottom section of page 5. Evaluations must be signed by the student and the immediate supervisor. Add additional employer. If you need to add an additional employer, you will need to submit a new Form I-983 to the Stand OPT Employment Update eForm. Only pages 1 to 4 of the I-983 need to be filled out. Change immigration status. If you change your status from F1 to a different visa status while on Stand OPT, you will be required to submit a final evaluation to the Stand OPT Employment Update eForm. The self-evaluations are on page 5 of Form I-983. For the final evaluation, you must fill out the bottom section of page 5. Evaluations must be signed by the student and the immediate supervisor. You will also be required to submit the F1 Demographic Update eForm with proof of your new visa status. SEVP accepts the following signature on Form I-983. Wet ink or handwritten signatures. Electronic signatures using software programs or applications. Electronically reproduce copies of a signature such as scanned image of a physical signature. SEVP does not accept typed signatures on Form I-983. If you use a typed signature, your Form I-983 will not be accepted. From the beginning of the authorization date listed on your EAD card, a student should be working or actively seeking employment. If you decide to quit your job or if you do not find a job, keep the unemployment rules in mind. Students who are granted a 24-month extension are given an additional 60 days of unemployment. During any initial 12-month period of post-OPT, students have 90 unemployment days. Any used unemployment days from post-OPT carry over to the same OPT period and are added to the 60 unemployment days granted for same OPT for up to a maximum of 150 unemployment days during the same extension period. Unemployment days are cumulative. Unemployment starts occurring from your approved OPT EAD start date. This is the date listed on your EAD card for days you are not working. If you accumulate 150 days or more of unemployment, you are in violation of your eForms status. You are expected to leave the US, transfer to another school, or change your visa status before the 150 years date. DISSC has created a self-guided Foreign I-983 review campus course that is open to all students. You can self-enroll in the course here. This course goes step-by-step through all reporting requirements, and we highly encourage all students on SAN OPT to review the content regularly. As a reminder, it is your responsibility to ensure you are following all reporting requirements while on SAN OPT. As always, DISSC is here to help answer any questions you may have. For more information, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit our website at issc.asu.edu. Thank you.